would be terrible decorator, wouldn't I?
Oh my god, I've got it on the table. I'm getting it everywhere. Hello guys, I hope you're doing well. Welcome back to my channel. If you can hear like a trickling noise, I've got my incredible like neon diffuser pod in the corner of my bedroom. Transformed my life, that device. It's like got a little light, it helps me fall asleep. For Christmas, stick that on your Christmas wish list actually. One of those diffuser pods, whether it's like an Amazon one, I've got the neon one up here, the white company one downstairs, I'm just a huge, huge fan. Anyway, hi and welcome back to my channel. This video is gonna be a little bit of a home update, sort of with no conclusive ending, so I apologize, but just kind of like updates that's happening around the house, a little bit of a chat and a ramble, and yeah, hopefully you guys find it enjoyable. I'm thinking of filming either like a room tour or a home tour within the next week or two. I just don't know if I'm ready for like a full home tour. So I'm sort of umming and ahhing about what to film, but I do want to show you like these rooms completed. Now the decorators are out, now I feel like I can get like finishing touches, like pictures, and just kind of get like finishing touches done in the room. So I think while that process is going on, I'm deciding what you want to see. So let me know what you want to see. Anyway, hi and welcome. Please check me out on my Instagram and my TikTok, and don't forget to subscribe here on my YouTube. I'll be so grateful for that. I'm gonna start with a little bit of an exciting inclusion in today's video. This video is partly sponsored by Desenio. I can talk for England when I work with brands because I love the brands so much and I just feel so excited, but I've got to keep it short and sweet. I've got the big box here and I'm gonna unbox it. I am so excited. Let me go get the box and we can talk. Okay, this is my big old Desenio order, so why don't we unbox it together? I've had Desenio prints for years. I had the prints at my mum's house that I'm sure lots of you may remember if you've been watching my vlogs for a while. Then I have Desenio prints downstairs in my living room. I will actually insert video clips of that because I'm such a Desenio fan. So I've already got prints downstairs in the living room from them.
Just wanted to show you guys the ones that I have in my living room to refresh your memory if you didn't watch my last Desenio video, which I think is probably like a year and a half ago now.
And there's so many areas in this house that I need to like Desenio up. If you do not know who Desenio are, they are a company that specialize in prints and frames. I am such a huge lover of the brand. And this is so exciting because this is a new frame that I've gone for. You guys see that? I'm gonna kind of unbox them all, put all the prints in the frame, and chat to you a little bit more once I've done that. I have a discount code with the brand. I'm gonna pop it on the screen for you guys right now. If you're looking to just like elevate your space a little bit, once you purchase the frames, you can just purchase the prints and change them out. So I've actually picked up some winter Christmas prints that I'm gonna change out in the living room. They have a feature on the website that I think is incredible where you can kind of like create your own art gallery on the wall and see what it would look like with the different prints before you order it. Absolutely adore that idea. So I'm gonna go ahead and pop all of the prints in here now, and then I'll show you guys what it looks like in my space. Oh my god, I'm just getting the prints out because I am just taking the like plastic off of the frame and getting ready to put the artwork in here. And I ordered this print for the downstairs living room. Oh my god, it is stunning. Like, I wanted something kind of wintry and whimsical for the upcoming winter season. And I ordered these like magical ones. This is so beautiful. It goes with the tones in this room. It just goes with the whole vibe. Another winter wonderland. Okay, sorry, that probably went right through you if you're wearing headphones. This is so cute. Okay, I'm gonna sort these out and I'll be back. Okay guys, I ordered a few kind of extra prints, as you do. I ordered so many extra prints because these are the ones that I wanna do downstairs. Just like really, really cute wintry prints. So they're gonna go downstairs. So that's kind of like a work in progress. But for my bedroom or my spare room, I ordered these because I just felt like, look, these are the tones in the room and these are the prints. I'm a little bit stuck for the final larger frame. So I've got either these hands with like a linen kind of vibe, or I've got this, which I do kind of love, or I have this one and it's kind of like relaxing too. I mean, that looks really nice as well. It's really like inoffensive. Okay guys, I just wanted to show you what they look like here. This is not where I'm gonna put them, but I guess you could put like smaller sized ones in like the paneling if I wanted to do that. Okay guys, and then this is what they look like over here. I am obsessed with them. I'm so happy with them. Oh, don't forget my code. I'll leave everything linked below if you guys want to check out Desenio for any prints. Hello guys, I want to share some updates with you guys. I feel like I haven't updated you in a hot minute. Let me spin the camera around and we can talk.
Okay, so this is my dining room. I'm gonna put a picture or a photo or a clip on the screen, ignore the paint by the way, of how this room was looking before the paneling. I have just had, literally yesterday, this beading, molding design put here on the wall. Now, please excuse the patchiness of this wall. This is all being repainted, so it doesn't matter. There's a really long story behind why this wall is patchy. To cut a long story short, I had a mix made. It wasn't really the right shade. I then ran and bought the Fire and Ball color. Clearly wasn't the right shade. Then I've come to find out that because I have candles a lot in this room, it's created like a smoke on the wall, which is terrible. I think you guys can see here. Just so, so bad. So this entire room is actually going to be repainted. There's lining paper that needs to be stuck down. These all need to come. I used to have pictures here, but I'm going to have a mirror here instead. All of these have got to come off out of the wall and be filled and sanded and sorted and la 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 la. But this is what the room currently looks like. I had this paneling put here. I'd wanted it for a really long time. If you guys have seen my house before, like, this is my living room. Excuse that plate there. It's a bit of a mess right now. But this is what my living room looks like. And I just love the things in this living room that I had put in. So I had, you guys will probably remember that watched my videos from way back when I got the house, these little alcoves, I had them like built in, these shelves and these cupboards with this really nice like kind of detailing with the black handles. Like, I had all this done and I absolutely love how it looks on either side. And I love this room. It's like my favorite room. I obviously have my bay window with my shutters. This lamp, by the way, is from the White Company. This chair I got from a like store in Marlow. And I love this chair. It's like a linen with this like little stud detail. I love it so much. Coffee table. Anyway, this is this room. You've seen this room 1,000 times, but I feel like this room is finished. I'm actually changing the prints here for different prints, so you guys will see that very, very soon. But I'm happy with the vibe, energy and feel of the room. And I always used to sit here on this little sofa and look into my dining room and just feel like it didn't look right, it wasn't finished properly. So we're re-judging it all. This table, by the way, I love. This is from Arini Bianchi. It's my favorite. These chairs are from, I want to say, the Cotswold Company or Cox and Cox. Actually, maybe Cox and Cox. I will leave them linked below. The sideboard is from Costco. Absolute winner, in my opinion. And I've kept the hardwood floor in here from the hallway and into the dining room. I did carpet that with like a wool just to give it more of a cozy feel. I had this built, by the way, these doors built and everything. But this hardwood floor, I've decided to keep this because I do think it's a really nice feature. Tempted to potentially sand this some point and have it a little bit lighter, but I kind of like the dark wood. Let me know. Rug is Zara, by the way. So we are painting this room, and this room is actually getting painted tomorrow. So because it's getting painted tomorrow, I've just gone and picked up 4 different paints to try. I need some for the bedroom because the whole bedroom is going to be repainted as well. I'll show you guys how that looks in a minute. But yeah, we've got to pick paints. So I did pick up 2 from Fire and Ball. I wanted Schoolhouse White, but they didn't have it. The current color I have in this room, I think, is Drop Cloth. I can't remember if it's Drop Cloth or Shade of White, but it looks too dark to be Shade of White. I'm pretty sure this is Drop Cloth. And in that room, I've got Shade of White. So I wanted Schoolhouse White, but they didn't have it in stock. So I ended up picking up Slipper Satin, which is this color here. And then I also grabbed, for anyone who's interested, Lime White No. 1, which is here. So that's Slipper Satin and Lime White. We're going to try them on the wall. And then I got 2 other colours from the, is this like the Dulux line, the Valspa line? And it's meant to be very, very similar to Fire and Ball because they do this like dead flat matte finish, which is lovely. You guys can't see the colours on these, but if you're wondering what these 2 colours are, that's Cappuccino Foam and this is Goose Feathers. Again, seen some good things about these online, so we're going to try these on the wall. We're going to give them all a go. I'm very excited and we can see what we're vibing. We're going to start out with Lime White. Okay. It's pretty white. Can you guys see that? I like it, but it's super light. It's almost white. Okay, that's Lime White. Okay, guys, this next one is Slipper Satin. This is probably not as white. Looks a little bit creamier. Lovely color, I like this. Very bright, but I want this room to feel bright. At the moment, it just feels way too dark in here. So this one on the left is Slipper Satin. I mean, there's no natural light at the minute. I'm doing this at nighttime. So when the sun comes out, I know I'm gonna see these a lot better. But this is Slipper Satin, and this is Lime White. So this has definitely got more of like a creamier undertone. This has got like probably like a cooler undertone. I don't know. The problem is the light in here anyway is super, super warm. Those are those 2 colours. Let's do some of these ones. This is a colour that I'm considering more for the bedroom. God, it really looks so green at the moment on my camera. I don't know what's going on. This is Cappuccino Foam. I'm not sure about this down here. Oh, it's quite pink. Quite pink. But I think in a bedroom it could be nice. I don't know. I got this everywhere. Well, it'd be terrible decorator, wouldn't I? Oh my God, I got it on the table. I'm getting it everywhere. Right, so that's Cappuccino, which is too white. It's way too white. So far, I'm liking Slipper Satin the most, which is this color. This is too bright, I think. Let's keep going though. This is fun.
I think this one might be the winner. This is Goose Feathers, which I have seen. It's called Lavish Lodge on Instagram. Rave about this color, and his house is to die for. Oh, it's quite gray. Kind of gray. Kind of love it though. Oh, I'm so confused, guys. Is this too gray?
Who freaking knows? I need to decide. Hello, guys. Good morning. I apologize for the state of me right now, but I wanted to carry on, obviously, showing you what we're doing to the house. I've literally been up all night, so I am exhausted. And then I woke up at 7 a.m. So I honestly am like half asleep right now, but determined to find a paint color for this bedroom. I'm obsessed with this color. Some of you guys asked me it. What color have you had in the bedroom? Obviously, we have had, I don't know if I've shown you this, we've had some paneling done. We've also had a wardrobe put in. I'll show you that in a minute. And I'm obsessed with this color, and I would just have this color. But this color seems to be discontinued everywhere. This was an Andrew Martin paint color in the shade Llama, for anyone who's wondering and loves the color like I do. But I think I have found a really, really good match. So I'm super, super happy. Let me show you what's been done in this room. Let me show you what's going on. Hello. I think I started explaining what we were doing in this room and my camera died and I've only just managed to plug it in. So it's much later on in the day, but I'm determined to show you guys this whole process and how it's actually going start to finish. So this is the paneling we have had done in this bedroom. Why does my camera look really crooked? I'm not too sure why. I am so, so happy with it. Obviously, it's all got to be painted. This whole room is being repainted. I think I mentioned that the shade that I had in here that I love is now discontinued, but I found a really, what looks like similar color. It's called Cappuccino Foam from V&Co. So we've had a whole rejig in this room. Obviously, they're going to pull this out and paint everything. This mirror, sadly, that I absolutely love, that's from Anthropology, that we had in here, is now too big for this alcove because obviously we've had a wardrobe put in. Leon, bless him, needed somewhere to put his clothes. I have two wardrobes in, we have like a tiny little box room at the back of the house, and I have those two wardrobes, so he needed somewhere. So the guys came in and built this, and I think it's so, so nice. When it's all painted, it's going to look great, but that's for him. And we had the big Anthropology mirror, this mirror here, but it's too big now. It doesn't fit that space. So this is going to be going into my dressing room, which I'm really excited about. It's such a huge mirror, but I love it. And then this is going to stay in this room. And it's really nice because it's given us just like that extra little bit of space. This is staying here. Please don't. The house right now is just wild. But I think if you've done a little bit of house renovation before and you've got decorators in and you've got things building and you know how it goes, this wardrobe is the same style as my dressing room. So if you've seen those wardrobes, it's going to be exactly the same. We're going to obviously have handles put here, and it's just got two rails all got to be painted. And Leon started putting his clothes in there. We then got this. This is like a new piece of furniture. Where did you buy this from?
Tops Furniture.
Tops Furniture. It was not a terrible price, was it? Yeah. Which obviously is a lot of money, but I feel like the Cotswold company and other companies that I've bought from have been astronomical. Yeah. It's really nice. My one pet peeve is that these drawers are not on runners.
You spray these as well.
Without That's what I was literally going to say. We're going to take all these off and we're going to spray these black, because obviously you guys know all the detailing in this house, all of like the knobs that I've got elsewhere, everything on the door, they're black. So that's what we're going to do here. It's quite a grey colour, this, but I don't hate it. It goes really nicely with this colour wall. This colour wall I've got here is a skimming stone mix from B&Q. So I think with that color, it just suits it. Okay, then this is the current state of the spare room. So we've had a whole rejig in here. There used to be a rail. Leon had all his clothes. We've moved everything around. So much going on. I bought these lamps from Dunelm. I really like the bases, but the lampshades are horrible. So I'm going to be ordering some new lampshades for them. I also want to get some artwork in here somewhere. I mean, give me some ideas. What do I put around this room? We need something. As much as I would love to have it all paneled, I just don't really want to spend the money and have the whole room repainted. So this is the situation. The shade on this wall, by the way, is Elephant's Breath by Fire and Bull. Got these bedside tables from Melody Maison, I want to say. And again, we're going to do the same thing with these. These are kind of like a gunmetal handle. They're going to be sprayed black, or I'm going to buy some new black handles for them. Like this bed so much because it's one of those airlift beds and you can store loads of stuff under it. This is the current situation here. So I've got this dressing table, which I did paint recently. I painted this in skimming stone, again from Fire and Bull. There seems to be a little makeup mark, or I've got, oh, actually, that's just wiping off. Okay, fine, I can just wipe that away. But I really like this. I just think it's pretty. I obviously need to sort this out. We want like a little mirror here. I think I'm gonna put curtains here. I'm gonna get rid of this blind, and I'm gonna just go to Dunelm and get like long curtains. I just think it's gonna look a lot more elegant. So that all needs sorting out. This chair needs to be moved. Please do not judge me for the house. Like, we are trying our best. It's just when you've got like people in like decorating, painting, and you have to like remove everything from the room, it is just so stress. Now to show you guys what I'm so, so happy with, and that is the color that we've had in this dining room. So you would have seen me last night trying all the colors on the wall, stressing because I didn't like any of the colors. I just
took a gamble and went for the colour Goose Feathers, which when I painted it on the wall, it looked so grey, and that's not what I want.
It was too grey.
But the colour that I had in this room was really green. It was too green for me. So there's one coat of it on the wall, on one wall right now, and I love it.
So this is the colour. I'm so happy. It does need another coat, and it's also dark now. So I feel like you guys cannot get the full effect of this colour. This is the colour Goose Feathers, and I love it. It really did look grey yesterday, but it isn't. It's like a perfect stone. So it's like not too grey, not too warm. I feel like you could team it with more cool toned things and warmer things in your house. I know a lot of people are moving away from the grey, which I've never really been someone that's been into grey. I just find it such a, like, for me, the colour's a little bit too cool and cold. However, saying that, I think it's really easy to watch these people that renovate their houses often. And, you know, that's not the real world. Like, if you renovate and paint your house, chances are you're not renovating and painting it again next year. So I think the fact that like trends come and go and people like greys out, if you've had your whole house painted grey and you like it, good for you. Like, I just think do whatever you like. Who cares if it's a trend or a, do what you like. But I think make sure you pick things that hopefully you're going to still like in like 5 years time, because if the trend does move on, you want to still like it for your house. Because I know a lot of people don't like beige. They say, oh, everything's too beige. I like beige. And for me, it's like a calm, you know, I want my house to feel calm and tranquil. And for me, that's why I prefer those tones. For some people, they're going to have like bright green walls. So yeah, but I think this color, Goose Feathers, is really, really nice. You can kind of see it a little bit with the contrasting of the coving. I mean, the lighting right now is dreadful. So this is what it looks like. I went for the finish, by the way, that is dead flat matte. I don't know if I mentioned that, but they do loads of finishes of this paint. And yeah, I'm just super, super happy with it. I mean, I'm not showing you guys it in the best light, but I think it looks great. I think the paneling looks amazing as well. So really happy with how this room looks. With regards to this room, ignore all of the, like, the shrubbery that's going on. A lot of this has come from the dining room and it's just currently in this room. Really happy with this room. I really like the color. I know it's quite a green color, but I do really like it. This is shade of white by Farinball, and this is a Farinball color. For anyone who's wondering, we are gonna have the carpet clean tomorrow. This carpet has just been well and truly destroyed. I'm making a rule as soon as this carpet gets clean that we're no longer eating in here, having drinks in here. Like, I just, it's a nice expensive wool carpet and I'm so sad that it is looking like this. So yeah, this is gonna be clean tomorrow. If for whatever reason the stains don't come out of this carpet, which there's a reason for a lot of these, I have decided that maybe not now, maybe in like 6 months time or something, I'm gonna go for a darker carpet in here, something that's going to be a little bit more hard wearing. I think at the time I loved this color tone and palette, and I still do, but I almost think the color of my jumper would have been perfectly fine as a carpet color and it would have been a lot more durable. So yeah, one piece of advice, do not go for cream carpet.
Tells you that when you're, you know, doing your house, don't go for a cream carpet, don't go for a cream sofa, and I ignored everyone. The sofa I think is like manageable, like mine's from IKEA. I just chuck a load of blankets over it, like it's fine. I didn't spend a load of money on the sofa. I think if you're going to spend thousands of pounds on a cream sofa, I would be terrified, but I just throw blankets over it, so it's always kind of got like something over it, and I can wash the cushion covers. Same with the walls, like I always think light walls look nice, but with the carpet, yeah. I am thinking, do I have like my wooden floor in there and do like a big rug? I just don't think it would be cozy enough, and I want that super like cozy living room feel. So those are all the current updates. I'm sure there's going to be more throughout the week, so I will keep feeding back. And yeah, if you've got any questions like in this blog that I don't answer about home stuff, definitely let me know. But I'm feeling much happier with how this looks down here. Like, I always felt something was off in this room, and now I feel like it's looking so much better and brighter, and I'm just so much happier with it already. Hello everyone, look at the state of me. Please don't judge my kitchen right now. It is like a laundry station. I've got like 7 piles of laundry here. Leon's been like doing an insane amount of laundry. This obviously is like a home update video, so I want to kind of show you where we're at. We have just had the finish of the rooms complete, as in all the painting is completely completed. I can now get in there and like rejig the room, sort everything out, and put it all together. So that's what I'm gonna do for you guys now. I think when I showed you this room, the painting last, it was at night, so all you could see was like the shadows on all the walls. So I'll show you now because you'll get a better vibe of what the color looks like. That's the color. So that is the color Goose Feathers. It's gorgeous. This room is now completely done. So is the bedroom. So I'll take you up there and show you that. And then I'm gonna obviously like rejig the room. I'm very tempted to do an updated house tour next week. Let me know if you wanna see that and I'll show you everywhere, cause I'm gonna like sort it all out. But I think it looks really, really good. He's touched up as well some of like the white woodwork, like the skirtings and just little things like that. I had like loads of holes in this wall, so he's like filled them in and smoothed all that. But yeah, I'm really happy with it. I think the color is so nice. Let me quick quickly whiz upstairs and I'm gonna show you guys the updates with the bedroom. And yeah, I'm thinking of doing an updated house tour. Maybe I should just do like a downstairs and an upstairs one in a separate video because the upstairs is not really done yet. Please excuse the state of the room again. This is the finish in this room. I mean, it's really hard to get good light in here because I have the shutters and I have this very warm light. It's hard to show you guys. I'm trying to send my mom a picture of the room and I just cannot seem to get the light right. Like, it looks like this is all not painted properly, but it's the shadow from my lovely light. The color in here that I went for is a lot kind of warmer. So this is called Cappuccino Cream and it's much more of like a warmer, pinkier kind of tone. I actually really like this. I wasn't sure when I first got home. I was a bit like, oh my God, I think I prefer the one downstairs. I actually love this color for a bedroom. I think it's a gorgeous bedroom color. It's really, really soft. Gonna sort all of this out, finish it all off. And we've just moved the mirror back in here. And then obviously this is the wardrobe. I need to get some handles for the wardrobe. So there's still lots of bits to do, but I feel like we're finally getting somewhere. I think when you're doing a house, it is not an overnight thing. Well, if it is for you, that's amazing. And look at my camera. I can't film like this. I'm gonna spin the camera around. Yeah, I think from social media, it can always seem that people do their house like overnight. Do you know what I mean? Like, oh my gosh, the house was transformed like in a day. That is not realistic. That is not how most people furnish a home. Most people do like room by room, bit by bit. They don't want to spend a fortune on furniture. Like, I just feel that wholeheartedly. So please never watch. I don't want anyone to watch my content and be like, she just has like, you know, disposable income to like furnish the whole house. I've had this house now for, I mean, I've had this house for like over 2 years, I think. And only now am I like properly finishing my bedroom and getting to a point where I'm like, oh, I'm getting quite happy with it. I feel like we're nearly there. There's little things, but I feel like I've sorted it. Same with like the spare room. Like, that's a mess at the minute. You know, the kitchen, like, I've never changed my kitchen. I was really lucky that when I moved into the house, the kitchen was like one that I could just, I was happy with it. I painted the cabinets, but that was it. So yeah, I just don't want you guys to think like these things happen overnight. They really, really don't. And everything is really expensive and it takes time. I don't know why I went on that random rant there. I don't know if it was a rant or I don't know if it was meant to make you feel better. Cause I think sometimes when I watch people's house tours and I follow a lot of home accounts on my home account, I see these beautiful houses and they look perfect 24/7. And I'm like, am I the only one that owns stuff? I just have stuff. I see these people's houses and they've got like one thing out on the kitchen island. And I'm like, how come I seem to have like seven things out on the kitchen island? Like, I just always have like a lot of stuff. So anyway, I'm really, really happy with where we're at with the house at the moment. I'll show you guys it at the end when I've kind of tweaked it a little bit, but there's still a little bit more to do. I think I'm tempted to do a house tour. I don't know. I feel like I should do an updated one because my last one that I did is when I got the keys to this house. And it would be really nice to insert clips from when I got the keys and compare how far we've got. So yeah, I'm gonna make myself some lunch and I'll catch up with you in a bit if I've got any more home updates.
Okay guys, so next up on my little DIY today is this little stool. So my mum very kindly gave me a little dressing table and stool that she had at her house that they were no longer using. It was literally in the shed. So I repainted the dressing table. I'll show you that in a minute. It's currently in our spare room and I'm gonna repaint the stool to match. I'm using Skimming Stone by Farrah & Ball and I've probably had this too long now, but we're gonna give it a go and see what happens. And then I'm actually gonna repurpose the top. I mean, it's got like makeup marks on it, like drink, you know, when you like spill your drink and like it's literally been through the ringer. So I'm gonna repurpose the top of it as well to like a similar fabric, to be honest, like a nice linen-y fabric, but something that maybe is not as light as this kind of cream color. So yeah, I'm gonna start my painting on here, but I just wanted to kind of show you what else I'm doing elsewhere today around the house.
Okay guys, and that is it for my home update. I really hope you all enjoyed this video. I know it was slightly chaotic, but hopefully it kind of explained what's happening with the house currently. Fingers crossed, I'm gonna be able to do a little bit of a house tour for you guys before Christmas. That's the aim. And then obviously show you guys what I'm planning for Christmas in this house, because I cannot wait to get my Christmas decorations up. I would love to do like a home tour before Christmas comes. Just to show you what we've done with the house since I last filmed a home tour video, which was forever ago now. I hope you enjoyed. Please don't forget to subscribe if you did. And check me out on my home account. I'm gonna leave it linked below. I'll put some pictures of my home account on the screen. I'm gonna try and be more regular at like posting over there. Things are coming along slowly but surely. So much love to you all. Have a fabulous week and a huge shout out to Desenio for working with me on today's video. Bye guys.